death rates increase among the young and less vulnerable, and the CDC finally admits that natural immunity actually works better. Over the past 2 years, we have seen absolute chaos in the reporting of what is going on in this pandemic. Whether it's complete incompetence or maybe even a little bit of malevolence, it's hard to know at this point. Maybe it's a little bit of both. But recently, the CDC came out with a new study, and I want to start with that because it's so interesting. So let's take a look first at the new study from the CDC. Protection from prior COVID-19 infections was better than protection from the COVID-19 vaccines against the Delta variant, according to a new study that was published by the CDC. And everything I mention here, this is not me making this stuff up. This is all on the CDC's website. You can look it up for yourself. Researchers analyzed health records from California and New York that were entered between May 30th and November 20th, 2021. Why those states in particular? Probably because they had some of the harshest caseloads during the entire pandemic. And it's very interesting because they had the harshest mandates, whether it was vaccination mandates or lockdown mandates, they really pushed it the hardest, but they still had the most cases. In these states, they separated the COVID-19 patients into four groups. And they looked at every possibility. They had unvaccinated with no previous COVID-19 diagnosis, unvaccinated with a previous COVID-19 infection, and then they took vaccinated with no COVID-19 infection, and then also vaccinated with prior COVID-19 infection. Now, what they found is those who had not received the COVID-19 vaccine, but were infected previously with the illness, were much less likely to test positive for COVID-19 when compared to those who were vaccinated and gotten COVID-19, according to the study, which was published Wednesday, this past Wednesday, in the CDC's Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report. Now, people who had not gotten a vaccine but did have a prior infection, also known as natural immunity, you know, that thing we've been talking about on this channel for a long time, that thing that basically even YouTube deemed did not exist. They took one of my channels down because I was boasting the powerful benefits of natural immunity working better over a year ago. Yeah, they took that video down. Well, what the CDC has shown us is that we're also less likely to land in a hospital than the vaccinated without natural immunity, according to the hospitalization records in California. Now, the conclusion of the study basically comes down to this, is that natural immunity with or without a vaccine provides a robust protection against hospitalizations in the age of Delta. My gosh. You know, for those of us who have actually been following the science, we've known this for many months. Well, why is it? I talked about it on this channel, actually. Israel released a study stating that natural immunity was 6 to 13 times more beneficial. And they did this, by the way, just months and months ago. This isn't new. This is old information at this point. But the CDC failed to recognize this. Instead, they ignored it. In the meantime, the government pushed for mandatory vaccines, promoting the firing of healthcare workers who refused to get vaccinated, and the healthcare workers who had natural immunity but did not receive the vaccine were forced to leave their jobs when, in fact, they were less likely to infect someone than those who were vaccinated and have not gotten the virus. They effectively dismantled healthcare for no reason, because the data already existed, but they chose to ignore it. And that's a crazy, crazy thing. And it's a crazy world we live in, because, you know, we keep hearing follow the science, and the people who are of real science, they're the same people who keep giving us the wrong information. We still, in fact, hear people stating that antibodies don't last. I recently, you know, had a patient tell me this. It's a made up story. We knew already people maintain antibodies 90 years after the 1918 flu pandemic. We also knew that people maintain antibodies from the 2003 SARS outbreak. So why would antibodies magically not last? There's been an effort to diminish the value of natural immunity from the very beginning of this. Recently, a patient who had told me that, well, the problem with the antibodies is they don't last. I said, where are you getting this information from? I said, I had the virus over 2 years ago. When I tested my antibodies recently, and T cell immunity and all these different things, I had the highest possible score you could get. Okay, and I know that that's different between individuals and healthy and not healthy and obese and, you know, someone who's fit. I know that that's different. But the point is that's a false statement. And many people are running around repeating it. They also pointed out in the CDC study that if you got a previous infection, booster or not, it doesn't reduce your risk. How does that make you feel if you've been told the whole time that you have to get all these boosters and all these things when you're finding out now that it doesn't even change the outcome if you get sick? So it's unbelievable information here. And this is important because here's the thing is when you blanket people with a vaccine, if they didn't really need it and it wasn't going to benefit them, let's just say it wasn't going to benefit them according to the data, you may very well be increasing a risk in their life that did not previously exist. Let's talk about another study that just came out. And this is regarding myocarditis in young people. What is happening out there? The numbers are huge. It's now clear for men, according to this study that was published in Nature, a very reputable journal, it's now clear for men younger than 40 that dose 2 and dose 3 of Pfizer have more myocarditis than SARS-CoV-2 infection. It's now clear for men younger than 40, dose 2 and dose 3 of the Pfizer vaccine have more myocarditis than SARS-CoV-2 infection. And this is true for dose 1 and dose 2 of Moderna as well. So they're not telling people of the risk associated with this, that the actual vaccine is causing more myocarditis than the infection itself. Pfizer boosters, dose 3, have more myocarditis for men younger than 40 than the infection. Myocarditis in this study, they show myocarditis post-infection is more common as you get older, in contrast with myocarditis post-vaccination, which is more common as you get younger. We're seeing a reverse gradient here. There is marked uncertainty as to whether dose 3 actually lowers severe outcomes and hospitalizations in young men. We just talked about this. The FDA is making a huge regulatory gamble with boosters, and they are cheered on by many who are not adapt to the data analysis. Boosting 16 to 40 year old men may not be in their best interest. It actually may be very detrimental to them. And we're just at this point not confident in it, but yet we are still hearing that you should just blanket this whole population with the shot. That's something that we have to consider. Now, this is where things get really interesting too, because there's Scott Davison, who is the CEO of an Indianapolis-based insurance company, One America. He was one of several business leaders and health professionals who spoke during a virtual conference that was organized by the Indiana Chamber of Commerce on December 30th. During his presentation, he had some very interesting things to say that we should not ignore. He said that the death rate among Americans aged 18 to 64 has skyrocketed by a jaw-dropping 40% compared to pre-pandemic levels. Now, Davison stressed that this was, you know, a huge, huge increase in numbers, which are the highest in the history of their business, which has been around for a very long time. I believe this company was over 100 years old, and they're seeing the highest death rate they've ever seen. Now, they're an insurance company. They're selling life insurance. They're paying attention to these numbers because this is what they do. And the increase, he clarifies, is not driven by deaths that are being classified as COVID-19 deaths. To put in perspective, Davison, who's the CEO of One America, he said that the massive spike in death in this age group is 4 times higher than that would be seen in a 1 in 200 year catastrophe, adding that 40% is just unheard of. It's not just One America that is seeing this trend, he said. He said it's every other single insurance company is seeing the same thing. What's most worrisome though, is that the biggest increase in excess deaths has come from traditionally healthier working age individuals under 65 and not the elderly who are most susceptible to COVID-19, getting COVID-19 and having a poor outcome. So all of a sudden, in regards to the timeline of this whole thing, they had a massive increase mid last year, right? He talks, you know, just before, prior to third and fourth quarter, they had this massive increase of deaths in younger individuals. Prior to that, it was, well, you know, it's the elderly who have a potential increased mortality rate if they get COVID-19. And now they're seeing this inverse relationship and it doesn't make any sense. And he's one of the first people who's saying this. And the interesting thing about this whole thing is that it's not his job to report this. And nor is he reporting it saying that, like, oh, something's really wrong here. He's just reporting the facts of what they see within their company. Now, as we go through this, we have to look at Israel as well. Israel, one of the most vaccinated countries in the world, sets a new COVID-19 case record. The Israeli Minister of Health announced this week that more than 72,000 people tested positive for the virus, the largest rise in infections since the start of the pandemic. Total active cases counted to nearly 400,000 people, of whom 533 are currently hospitalized in critical condition, according to their January 19 statement posted by the country's health ministry. Now, Israel, which is one of the highest COVID-19 vaccination rated places in the world, they have nearly half of their population, half of their citizens who have received three shots, meaning they got the first two and then they've gotten boosters after that. They are now leading the world in new daily cases per capita, according to their January 20th data. Now, we see this time and time again. Those who have the strictest rules and mandates around vaccines and lockdowns tend to have the poorest outcomes. We've seen that in the United States with like California, in New York, and we're seeing this across the world. Many places around the world are getting very frustrated, saying, you know what? Why are we continuing to do this? We're seeing this data. It's not proving any of these things we've been pushing with the mandates and the lockdowns and vaccinations. It's not proving to be beneficial. Why are we continuing to do this? Recently, we saw the UK drop all mandates, the vaccine passports, everything, because they're out, they're done, they're not having it anymore. We're seeing country after country follow suit in this because they realize that all of these things that they're doing are hurting rather than doing good. Now, what we have to pay attention to here are the same things that we've been talking about here on this channel the whole time. And that's that we have to really promote natural immunity. Now, to basically learn more about natural immunity and all the things that you can do, you can always go and become a member at Dr. Z TV, because this is not only where we are able to provide this kind of information to you because of your support and your donations, but also we make sure that we're giving you the proper information that you can live your life and not have to worry about whether or not there's another pandemic or virus that you have to be afraid of, simply because all along you're doing the right things. You're not obese. You're making sure that you're focusing on reversing any comorbidities you have. But also, we focus on natural immunity as well and all the things you can do. Recently, we had a paper that we put onto the membership portal that talked about how you can nebulize as we look at how we can improve our health naturally, in our immune system naturally. We have to look at natural immune boosting vitamins. We have to make sure that we're eating healthy and cutting out sugar from our diet and exercising every day. We have to get out there and get moving. And then we can take immune boosting supplements in order to further help boost our immune system up so that it can fight off any virus and any bacterial infection. What I'll do is I'll put a link below to my favorite immune boosters that you can use in order to transform your health. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, I think you'll really like this video over here next.